Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for the possibility having a presentation in front of such important and interesting community. I will try to keep my limit, but I'm not sure because I have prepared 50 slides. No, sorry, only 10 slides. The topic we discuss is for us as the soldiers, as the citizens in uniform, indeed fundamental. The security situation in our countries and in the world has been changing. We have to face new challenges, new threats, global warming and migration. There is an ongoing deterioration in global peace over the last 10 years. This is not good news. On this slide, you can see the result of the 12th annual report of the Institute for Economics and Peace, published in summer 2018 in London. You can find it on visionofhumanity.org. The report says that the world has become less peaceful over the last 10 years, mostly due to conflicts in the Middle East and Africa. Of the 9 global regions, the Institute identified Europe as the world's most peaceful. Good news for us. Of the 5 most peaceful countries in the world, 4 are in Europe. Interesting. Iceland, Austria, Portugal, and Denmark. For instance, Germany is 17th, Slovakia 22nd, France 71st. But 23 of the countries classified as Europe deteriorated in peace in 2017, mainly in Western Europe, with Eastern Europe improved overall. What is peace? What does it mean? Peace is not just the absence of war. The Global Peace Index is calculated on the basis of 23 indicators in 3 areas. Security on society, ongoing conflicts, and militarization. In the field of security in society, the Institute for Economics and Peace looks at the murder rate, the number of people in prison, the number of police officers, and also perceptions of crime. The area of militarization includes the number of soldiers, the military spending in relation to economic output, and also possible arms exports. The report methodology also introduced the category positive peace for the first time this year. This treats peace not only as the absence of conflict and war, but takes into account structures, social factors, and institutions that contribute to the peacefulness of societies. Analyzing the current situation in Europe, we can say the main current threats we are facing too are migration, global warming, extremism, and terrorism. Sure, we can discuss about it. Many politicians do it. But we can agree all these factors have big influence in the Global Peace Index. Migration is caused very often by global warming, and both trigger extremism and terrorism. But we want to focus our attention on the first two, on migration and global warming. The rising global temperature has had the crucial influence into the global environment. Currently, we observe more and more in our countries storms, tornadoes. Remember Hurricane Florence or Michael, the storm Fabian in Northwest Europe or Storm Zorba in Greece. Snowstorms, rainfalls, rising water levels. On the other hand, lack of rain heats fires. It could be so devastating that it can fully destroy big area of the country, its villages, cities, power plants, communications, fields, forests. The bad situation in the homeland mostly leads to migration, forcing the people to find better place for life, for their families, their children. Migration, it means very often new people from very, very different countries. It means new culture, new habits, new religion, very often hardly compatible with native citizens, less resources for the native regular community, and in the end, it's going to the deterioration in global peace in the country. This is and will be new situation for the armed forces, for the commanders and all military personnel. This will be not a regular war, no enemies in front of us, no enemies using explosives, bombs and lethal weapons. We will conduct much more search and rescue and transport missions, find and evacuate citizens from the ruined area. We will need more firefighters, medics, and evacuation and supply capabilities like providing by water, food, and housing. In the end, we will rebuild the destroyed region and rebuild the country. In these areas, we need to focus our effort to improve our military capabilities and skills. This will require better coordination with local and state authorities and, of course, new approach to the training of our troops. But I want to speak about the future training of our armed forces. It is a really wide topic. I want to focus our attention on the cornerstone, on the base, on the fundament each army, which is very often overlooked by our leaders. The leaders of the countries are willing to meet a much higher level of spending to the armed forces, to spend more resources to build a stronger national defense. But they are speaking mostly about new weapons, new or more modern equipment, tanks, fighters. Our leaders and we have forgotten the cornerstone of the armed forces, and it is the personnel, both military and civilian. The economy of our countries is doing well. The rate of unemployment is sinking. In Slovakia, it is from 15% in 2011 to approximately 5% this summer. The average salaries are growing. It's a good situation for the country, but not so good for the military recruiting centers. You can see the situation in the Slovak Republic. I have prepared the statistic from years 2011 and 2017. You can see the number of personnel given in DOEs. This is blue line. The numbers are rising from 14,750 up to 16,150 soldiers. More than 1,400 soldiers, it's about 10%. It's okay, because we have increased our capabilities mainly in field ISTAR and the special forces. But the real number of military personnel is going down. Down, it is this red line. From the year 2011, less and less. Small exception is year 2015, the year when the new law for the military service came into force. More motivation for the personnel, that the provision for the service higher benefits. But it lasted not for long. In 2017, we have less than 3,800 soldiers. This is 23% less. The continued tendency you can see on the next slide. It is still going down. This is quite bad perspective. This year we have only 75 of personnel we need. I know that many states in Europe have the same problem. What is the reason for it? I'm convinced we can simply answer this question. The service for the armed forces is not so attractive as for other employers. And I'm sure that this is the only answer. On the next slide, you can see the numbers of applicants for the military service, green line. In 2017, it is one-third less than in 2011. The blue line shows that maybe one-half of applicants have met the physical, mental, and other requirements. Till 2014, we had budget limitation. We could not engage all applicants who were able for service. Blue and black line are the same after 2015. We have had enough money, but we haven't had enough applicants. If we won't have stronger and better equipped, trained and prepared armed forces, we need the cornerstone of each organization, and it is personnel. Not regular citizens, but citizens in uniform. We need more soldiers, highly motivated, best trained, willing to serve and die for homeland. We have to go on open market with better benefits for the service, for the retirement, with better benefits for the military families. It's not only salary, it is also better working conditions, social, medical, psychological treatment and care. It is a complex of measures. The soldiers have to be sure that their beloved, their families, children are secured and safe during their missions. Because our soldiers have to be confident and dedicated, faithful and loyal, best trained and willing to sacrifice life. Our first and most important challenge is to replenish, to restock, to complete our armed forces, firstly with personnel. Then we will have the conditions for training, we will be able to adopt new capabilities and skills. And I'm persuaded that the army is strong, as strong its own soldiers are. Thank you.